Some right-thinking Nigerian ministers have joined Governor Otom, saying he's not at war with the president. The president just needs to tell Nigerians on which side he's on, take more decisive and drastic actions, measures to bring an end to the current insecurity plaguing the country. I guess these ministers, if you look at them closely, are ministers whose land and people have been affected, and maybe their conscience has been pricked. And so they say, you know what, why stay on the sideline of those who do not mean well for the people? And as such, have joined Governor Samuel Otom in the call to end insecurity, which is the major crime he has committed against this administration. Governor Otom of Benue State continued to tell this administration that you are silent over the activities of Fulani herdsmen. This is not a way to go. We need to be honest if we want to end these current things going on. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. Let's get all the details. Thank you. A former Minister of Steel Development in the Second Republic, Paul Ugo, has joined in the Benue State government's call on the federal government to take more drastic measures to end the instant killing and displacement of people in the states. The former chairman of the Northern Elders Forum, who insists that the governor has nothing personal against President Muhammadu Buhari, has been portrayed, and as some members have portrayed him, members of the National Assembly, to take a decisive decision on what is going on currently in Nigeria. This is no longer the Nigeria we used to know, where people can go about their livelihood, travel even at night. Even daytime travel now is a big issue, and much more traveling in the night. The presidency must not take this as a war. I don't think Otom is at war with anybody, but only shouting out and seem not to be heard by all that is currently ravaging the country. The Second Republic Minister of Steel spoke out over the worsening security situation in the state, which is making his home state governor portrayed to be having a personal fight against the president. A just call. The ancestor wants members of the National Assembly to be more committed to the fight against insecurity and speak out. Senators, House of Rep members representing Benue State must stand up together and condemn the silence by this administration on the current killing ongoing. With the number of displaced persons on the rise on a daily basis, with much more bandits killing people, the former minister is backing Governor Otom to say enough is enough. He has no fight, personal issue with the presidency, but a call to end the senseless killing and the activities of killer Fulani herdsmen. So there you have it. Well-meaning and well-thinking Nigerians are rising up and saying there is a reason for us to rise up at this point in time and not pretend that all is well. People are dying. A lot of things are happening. We cannot fold our arms and pretend that nothing is going on currently speaking today. And so he's saying what is going to happen is we are going to ensure that we continue to speak out and let the world know exactly what is happening. The current administration wants to put everybody down, however way they want to do it, to ensure that, you know, people are intimidated and unable to speak, unable to raise their voice, unable to rise up to the current predicament. Governor Samuel Otom has not been silent on the activities going on in his state against his people. This is the people he swore an oath to protect, to serve and to protect. Sadly, these things are happening and nobody seems to be very concerned and is saying this is not acceptable. This is the very crime that this governor has committed. As you can see, that the current administration is after him as though he has killed their child. You see, this is the crime the governor has committed. And that's why nobody can be silent, you know, on this current issues ongoing. So what do we do? Everybody rises up to the occasion and we say no. You see? So governor, some ministers, you know, even former ministers are standing up with Governor Samuel Otom and saying to the world, so people do not misunderstand this man. Say, listen, he has no personal grievances or no personal grief with whoever it is. He's only calling out and he's only speaking and saying enough is enough. is only rising up, you know, from all that is happening and saying what is going on is not acceptable. We're not going to fold our arms and allow it to happen. This is the call and this is the cry of what he's doing. Nothing more, nothing less. He's not asking anybody for anything. He's not asking for, he's just saying enough is enough. And is that too much to ask? I don't think so. I don't think that is too much to ask. I don't think that is too much to ask. So, I mean, what's the worst that can happen? What's the worst that can really happen? So people need to rise up. People need to stand up for what is true. People need to, you know, be able to say, we've had enough. Yeah, we've had enough. Because this administration will say nothing as the Fulani herdsmen are committing atrocity and ravaging the country. We all know what is going on. Everybody is aware. Everybody knows about the activities of the Fulanis. How come everybody is damn so quiet? All the governors, senators, vice presidents, everybody is just quiet. Is there more to it? Is there another secret agenda ongoing on these things? Why is everybody silent? So this is the main point of action. Why Otom's minister is saying, well, I don't think he has a personal issue or a personal problem with Buhari. Buhari should tell Nigerians what the real issue is. He should tell Nigerians, you know, why is he not addressing the issue? Why is he saying nothing about the current predicament? How come he's very comfortable to go ahead and have a lavish wedding on his son when children are still in captivity, yet he calls himself the number one citizen who swore with an oath to protect Nigerians and defend them from this very predicament that they find themselves? How come he's silent in the face of all that is going on? How come? Because when people speak, then they begin to pick on them, that they are picking on Buhari. I don't understand what they are picking on Buhari for. What are they picking on Buhari for? Is it that bad? Is it the only one? But if you have not done what you should do, you should not expect anything less. People will ask you questions. Those questions are what he's trying to run away from. And he doesn't have a choice here, you see. He has to answer to the people. Because he has not done well. He hasn't done well at all. So this is what is happening. This is what is going on. And, you know, people are standing up for Governor Samuel Otom saying, you've done well, my brother. Don't allow anybody to intimidate you. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Subscribe if this is your first time. Don't forget you have a voice. Thank you so much. God bless you. Bye for now.